everyone. Today we'll be discussing the quick solutions of All India Akash Test Series JEE Advanced Test 1A Paper 1, which was held on 17th November 2019. Let us start with the multiple type questions first. Question number 37 says that, let alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 and alpha 4 are the roots of the equation x raised to the power 4 minus 7x plus 1 equal to 0. Then we have to answer the following options. Now in the options we are given xi upon 1 plus xi. So let us make the equation whose roots are x upon 1 plus x. So for that, let us substitute y equal to x upon 1 plus x. So from here we will get y plus xy equal to x. So y is equal to x minus xy. So from here x is equal to y upon 1 minus y. So if we substitute here x as y upon 1 minus y, so the equation becomes y upon 1 minus y whole raised to the power 4 minus 7 times y upon 1 minus y plus 1 equal to 0, right? So this is y raised to the power 4 minus 7y multiplied with 1 minus y whole cube plus y minus 1 whole raised to the power 4 equal to 0. Further solving this, we will get plus 7y into y minus 1 whole cube, and that will be minus 3y square plus 3y plus whole square equal to 0. So that is further equal to 8y raised to the power 4 minus 7y minus 21y cube plus 21y square plus 4y square plus 2y square minus 4y minus 4y cube equal to 0. So coefficient of y raised to the power 4 is 9y raised to the power 4 from these two, and coefficient of y cube, that will be minus 25y cube, and coefficient of y square is 21 plus 4 plus 2, that is 27y square, and coefficient of y is minus 11y plus 1 equal to 0. So roots of this equation are alpha I upon 1 plus alpha I. So sum of the roots will be equal to 25 by 9, and product of roots will be equal to 1 by 9. So from the given options we can see that sum is equal to 25 by 9 and product is 1 by 9. So answer will be option number A and C. Next, let's discuss question number 38, which says that the equation x minus 1 whole raised to the power 4 plus x minus 3 whole raised to the power 4 equal to k has how many roots for the given range of k. So for this type of question, we always firstly substitute x minus 2 equal to t, right? So what we get from here, x is equal to t plus 2. T plus 1 whole raised to the power 4 plus t minus 1 whole raised to the power 4 is equal to k. So solving this further, we will get 2 times t raised to the power 4 plus 6t square plus 1 equal to k. That is, t square plus 3 whole square is equal to k by 2 plus 8. That is, t square is equal to k by 2 plus 8 under root with plus minus sign, and here we have minus 3. Now for 4 distinct real roots, both the roots should be positive, which is not possible because minus 3 minus under root of k by 2 plus 8 is always negative. That is, minimum 2 imaginary roots are always there. minimum two imaginary roots are always there, which means that option number B is correct, right? Now, for two real roots, minus 3 plus root of k by 2 plus 8 should be greater than 0 for two real distinct roots, right? So, let us solve this. We will get k by 2 plus 8 should be greater than 9, that is k should be greater than 2. That is, when k is greater than 2, then we will get two real distinct roots, which means that option number C is correct. And option number A says that four distinct real roots, which is never possible. Option number D says that not more than two distinct real roots for any k belonging to R. That is also true. That is, maximum two real roots can be obtained. So, answer is option number B, C and D. Next is question number 39, which says that if z is a complex number such that z plus 1 plus iota is equal to modulus of z, then we have to answer the following questions. So, very simple question from complex number. Let us directly put z equal to x plus iota y. So, what we will get? X plus 1 plus iota times y plus 1 is equal to mod z, that is under root x square plus y square. So, equating real and imaginary part. When we equate imaginary parts, then we get y plus 1 equal to 0 and x plus 1 is equal to root of x square plus y square. So, from here we get y equal to minus 1. So, putting it here, we get x plus 1 whole square equal to x square plus 1. So, opening this, we will get x square plus 1 plus 2x equal to x square plus 1. That is, 2x is equal to 0, which means that x is equal to 0 and y is equal to minus 1. So, our complex number is minus iota. So, we have to find the relation between z and z bar. Now, z bar is equal to iota. So, we say that z is equal to minus of z bar. So, option number B is correct. And for z equal to minus iota, we know that argument is minus pi by 2. So, this option is incorrect. And modulus of z is definitely 1. So, correct answer is option number B and D. Next is question number 40, which says that consider a function fx equal to x plus 1 upon x square plus x plus 4, then which of the following is correct? Now, firstly, we have to find domain of fx. To find domain, let us find the points where the function is not defined. For that, we will put x square plus x plus 4 equal to 0. Now, we can see that this is equal to 0 for no real value of x, which means that domain of fx is all real value. That is, option number A is correct. Now, we have to find the range of fx. So, let us put x plus 1 upon x square plus x plus 4 equal to y, right? So, from here we get x plus 1 equal to yx square plus yx plus 4y. So, let us make quadratic in x. So, we will get x square into y plus x into y minus 1 plus 4y minus 1 equal to 0. Now, as x can take real values, so its discriminant is greater than equal to 0, which means that y minus 1 whole square minus 4y into 4y minus 1 is always greater than equal to 0, which means y square plus 1 minus 2y minus 16y square plus 4y is greater than equal to 0. That is, minus 15y square plus 2y plus 1 is greater than equal to 0. Which further means that 15y square minus 2y minus 1 is less than equal to 0. Right? Now, this can be written as 5y plus 1 into 3y minus 1 is less than equal to 0. Which means that y will belong from minus 1 by 5 up till 1 by 3. So, this is the range of fx. So, option number B is incorrect. Now, 1 minus root 3, that will be 1 minus 1.73, that is minus 0.73. and minus 1 by 5 is minus 0.2, so it is not lying in the range. So this is also incorrect. Root 5 minus 2, that is definitely lying in its range. So correct answer is option number A and D. Next is question number 41, which says that consider two sets A and B such that A union B intersection 1, 2, 3 is equal to set 2, 3, 4, 5. Then which of the following is or are correct? Now here it can be seen that if we talk about number 1, then number 1 will not belong to set A and it will not belong to set B. 1 will not belong to A and 1 will not belong to set B. Also, A should definitely have elements as 4, 5. A should definitely have elements 4, 5. Otherwise, we will not have on the right hand side 4, 5 elements. Right, because from here we are getting intersection, right? So from here we will get 2, 3, and in A we should definitely have the elements 4, 5, and we can have element 2 or 3 or both, right? So let us look at the options now. Option number A says that 1 belongs to A union B. That is definitely incorrect. 1 belongs to A dash intersection B dash. Let us say we talk about Venn diagram of A and B. So A dash intersection B dash is this area, and 1 is not belonging to either A or B. So 1 belongs to A dash intersection B dash. This option is correct. Minimum value of number of elements in A is 2. That is true. Minimum number of elements in A is 2 and maximum is 4, right? Minimum value of number of elements in B is 2. That is not correct, because in B minimum number of elements is 0, right? So correct answer is option number B and C. Next is question number 42, which says that if the equations x square minus x plus lambda equal to 0 and 2x square plus x plus lambda equal to 0 have a common root, then the value of lambda may be. Very basic question. Let us solve it. We have two equations as x square minus x plus lambda equal to 0, and the other one is 2x square plus x plus lambda equal to 0. So we know the condition for common root. Let us write it down. X square divided by minus lambda is equal to x divided by 2 lambda minus lambda is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 2 by cross multiplication. So this can be written equal to 1 by 3. So x square is equal to minus 2 lambda divided by 3, and x is equal to lambda by 3, which means that minus 2 lambda by 3 is equal to lambda square by 9. So from here we can say that either lambda is equal to 0 or minus 2 is equal to lambda by 3, that is lambda is equal to minus 6. So we get two values of lambda from here, that is 0 and minus 6. So correct answer is B and D option.